Oh yes, welcome back to Skyrim Reach with updated Imperial Nightblade Vampire tank build for PvE and PvP. How can be that? We got minor toughness at 10% of max of health, then the Vampire stage 4, under 50% attack, 33% less damage, and the fire issues doesn't matter because I got so much health. This is really insane. We use like the Lord 3000 of health and food and pots. Let's go take a look. Double Blood Mary if you need it. And Ozargus triple pocket, which gives 5000 of health with 457 of recovery. But you could run also with 3 stat food if you like. This is on your playstyle. Recommended essence of weapon power for major brutality, more crit, stamina and a stamina recovery. And let's go take a look on the main stats. 85k of health with a 2000 of stamina recovery. And yeah, because I use 2 siphon ability for this season, more siphon ability. And when you drink your potion, you got 1900 of weapon damage with 32% of crit. If you got the PvP buff, goes up to 35%. And the resistances is 30 of spell resistances with 28k of physical. With Shimmering Shield, you reach over 30k. Let's take a look on the back bar. We got the 80k of health with 2000 of stamina recovery, 1600 of weapon damage. And if I activate the Cypher ability and I use my potion, 1900 of weapon damage with 35% of crit with 2311 of stamina recovery. And if you use your Shimmering Shield, which you told before, 31 and 29k. Rad. Yup, set 1 is the Black Doctor Sword in Nirnhorn with 348 of weapon damage and the shield infused 1144 of health, and you could use also a posing, but I don't like. On the back bar, the same sword, but I have there in sharpened, so we have to transmute that also in Nirnhorn for push up a 15% of the whole damage over time and your abilities. Whoop! And so we have also Nirnhorn with 348 of for 5 seconds. When I reapply that, you can change that on the main or back bar. I like it on both bar without poisons, man. We completed with the Black Doctor jewelry. The necklace is in healthy with 167 of stamina recovery, and also both rings, both healthy with stamina recovery. The glyphs are not in gold. You could put 2 golden glyphs for have more stamina recovery, and 1000 of health, 1000 of health, 4% of healing taken, and 4000 of health, which stacks with the whole sets and race, man, which is really insane. And you see, it's 5, 3 jewelry and 2 weapons, like 5. And the second set are the Warp Poet in Infused, and we have a Waste in Divines for push up the Lord. We have the hands, also divines, and the legs, divines. Make the legs and infuse it. And the feet in divines, and you have 1000 health, 2800 of spell and physical resistances with 1000 health, and 10% of max of health, which stacks with the whole build. Yeah. Monster set separately, we have 2 different. So you see 1144, and every gives you additional health trait, which is pretty insane, and stack up with the whole build skills and buffs. You could run also Welcome Scoria, but then you lose 4k of health, and Scoria works with damage over time. Yes. We have Structured Entropy, 8% more of health, magical damage over time with a heal over time, and Major Sorcery, which is pretty good. Invigorating Drain is your heal, 80k of health in 3 seconds back, and you can bar cancel swap that, so you are not in the shit. Shadow Image, this is a really funny ability as a tank in the PvP especially, and also in the PvE, can takes you off the pressure and teleport you to the shadow. I teleport behind you. Hello guys, I'm here. Zack on the other side. You see how this works, and this is based on the build, the spiked bone shield, 90% damage shield of your health in the PvE is 38%, and you swap back on the melee attackers at 38%, and is also a synergy that can heal up, but the main is for swap back the damage and the high health or shield. The piercing diamond for major breach and major fracture, and when that crit is also not bad, fake 5 or 6k of damage. And that's your ulti on your main bar, which takes a 30% less damage. And then on the back bar, you have a surprise then. Makes magic damage over time. It's a ring, 70 seconds. You can be immortal if you like. If you combo then the exclusive mist together, which costs a lot and stops the recovery, but 70 seconds you can do with the potion. Then on the back bar, structured entropy for half, same 8% more of health with a small health over time and the magic damage over time and the major sorcery which are needed for your abilities just for boost up a little bit your damage. This is a tank build, but same exclusive mist in the PvP for a major expedition, increases your movement speed by 30% for 4 seconds and you take less damage 75%. Then with your ulti, 100%. With Assort Magic, you absorb 25k of damage in the PvP and 50% of your max of health and 46k in the PvE. And when you block, you take less damage and cost less. The Mirage gives you the major evasion on a tank build. Are you crazy? And a little bit more of resistances. And that's your finisher. The Caesar's damage, 300% more of damage, under 25% of health, and the Leering Swarm for heal you up when you are attacked by many, 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 and you make a magic 1900 magic damage every second. Yes, let's go see in the champion points. 56 in the Warlord for 20% of break free, and a Sprinter 3, Mooncalf 75 for the stamina recovery, and Tenacity on the heavy attacks, plus 25 makes 35%, and here 2% of mobility and tumbling, 19% with Blasted, which goes with Invigorating Drain. You heal you very good up, and also when you drink a potion, 80% of less cost. Master of Arm for your abilities, direct damage and precise strike when you crit as plus 10% as a Nightblade, and Mighty 43 you have to put in to exploit the passive, and here Heroism, you gain Ironclad 20%, pretty important, is key with a little bit of spell shield, and here 921 when you come crit in, so when 10 crits come in, you heal you up fast. Thick Skin, 11 in Elemental Defender, and 7 in Hardy. Bastion, 100% with your Bone Shield, which fits pretty good, and I love it, and all these passives when you take up your damage shield. And yes, that was it for this troll. The stats, something about the build. I use it for the PvE and PvP. In the PvE, it's possible to beat Veteran Dungeon by your own if you need a helmet and your friends don't have time, for example, or you wanna try out how much damage the build can take, so you can use it in the PvE. You practically never die and you can heal up in 3 seconds your 80 or 90k of health. That depends how much siphon ability you slot and how you make that with the skills. And this is a really mechanical function, very strong build. Also in the PvP, when you run in a small scale group, you never die first, and second, you help a lot your friends. But if you battle one versus one, so you can win if you are a little bit more skilled. It takes a little bit time for taking down a good PvP player with this build, so this is not the most DPS build that you can find maybe on my channel if you like. This is Tinkered for exploit the PvP alone by never dying. And yeah, you can take pressure from 3 or 4 small scale versus you. This is possible, but maybe you don't die, but you neither kill them. typisch.